Magnificat, magnificat, magnificat anima mea, Dominum, magnificat, magnificat, magnificat anima mea, magnificat, magnificat, magnificat anima mea, Dominum, magnificat, magnificat, magnificat anima mea. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your
Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Kyrie eleison. Christe eleison, Kyrie eleison. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. Grant, Lord God, that we, your servants, may rejoice in a falling health of mind and body, and through the glorious intercession of Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, may we set free from present sorrow and come to enjoy eternal happiness through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. The priests and prophets said to the princes and to all the people, "This man deserves death. He has prophesied against this city, as you have heard with your own ears." Jeremiah gave this answer to the princes and all the people. "It was the Lord who sent me to prophesy against this house and city, all that you have heard. Now, therefore, reform your ways and your deeds. Listen to the voice of the Lord your God, so that the Lord will repent of the evil with which he threatens you. As for me, I am in your hands. Do with me what you think good and right. But mark well, if you put me to death, it is innocent blood you bring on yourselves, on this city and its citizens. For in truth, it was the Lord who sent me to you, to speak all these things for you to hear." Thereupon the princes and all the people said to the priests and the prophets, "This man does not deserve death. It is in the name of the Lord our God that he speaks to us." So Ahikam, son of Shaphan, protected Jeremiah, so that he was not handed over to the people to be put to death. The word of the Lord. Lord, in your great love, answer me. Rescue me out of the mire. May I not sink. May I be rescued from my foes and from the watery depths. Let not the flood waters overwhelm me, nor the abyss swallow me up, nor the pit close its mouth over me. But I am afflicted and in pain. Let your saving help, O God, protect me. I will praise the name of God in song, and I will glorify him with thanksgiving. See, you lowly ones, and be glad. You who seek God, may your hearts revive. For the Lord hears the poor, and his own who are in bonds he spurns not.
Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for there is the kingdom of heaven. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Herod the Tetrarch heard of the reputation of Jesus and said to his servants, "This man is John the Baptist. He has been raised from the dead. That is why my powers are at work in him." Now Herod had arrested John, bound him, and put him in prison on account of Herodians, the wife of his brother Philip. For John had said to him, "It is not lawful for you to have her." Although he wanted to kill him, he feared the people, for they regarded him as a prophet. But on the birthday celebration for Herod, the daughter of Herodians performed a dance before the guests and delighted Herod so much that he swore to give her whatever she might ask for. Prompted by her mother, she said, "Give me here on a platter the head of John the Baptist." The king was distressed, but because of the oaths and the guests who were present, he ordered that it be given, and he had John beheaded in the prison. His head was brought in on a platter and given to the girl, who took it to her mother. His disciples came and took away the corpse and buried him, and they went and told Jesus. The Gospel of the Lord. As we can see in the first reading and then in the Gospel, it is not easy to be a prophet. The prophecy was and is a dangerous business. In our first reading, Jeremiah risked his life to saying, "Reform your ways and your deeds." And then in the Gospel, we have John the Baptist. And he gave his life for standing up to Herod. And these prophetic messages from the first reading from the Gospel and from all the prophets throughout the Bible, they are not easy. But we have to have those kind of messages to straight up our life, to follow God, to follow Jesus Christ, because those messages are from God. Those messages are from God to line up our life, to put us on the path, on the truth, to put us back to the peace and freedom. And of course, the King Herod could reject those immoral proposition, this immoral request from Herodians. But he was worried about how people may think about him, and he was too weak to resist. And that's why we have to have Jesus as our friend, to be strength. Because some days it may be our task to call others to repentance, like John or Jeremiah. In this case, we have to remember that love must be in the center of our message. Whenever we are approaching somebody, we have to approach with love. And only through the God grace, we can respond to that vocation. We can respond to that call from Jesus to be the prophets in our world. Because we, through our baptism, through our gospel, we have to show others that Jesus Christ is our Savior. And it's not easy to be the prophet. It's not easy to preach the truth, as I said before. But with the Eucharist, with that encounter with God, we can do it. Because everything is possible with God. And as John Paul II used to say, totus tus per Mariam, all yours through Mary. And we also have the Blessed Mary as a great advocate. And we have to pray through her that we can be worthy to be with Jesus Christ, that we can receive from that altar power and strength. But we have to have that blessing, we have to have that strength, that power, and that power comes from Jesus Christ. But we have to beg, we have to pray through Mary. And John Paul II was a great advocate of truth. He was preaching the truth. He was preaching the gospel all the time. And we soon will be honored because we're going to have the first cross relics of John Paul II. We're going to have his altar built over there. And we are waiting for that. So we have all the saints. We have Blessed Mary to encounter God, to be in the union with Jesus Christ, with all the saints. And that's why we are here, because we are asking God, we are asking Holy Spirit that the Holy Spirit can enter into our lives and change our lives. Because Holy Spirit changed the lives of the disciples, so for sure the Holy Spirit is able to change our lives, to put the new hope, new strength, new power into our lives, into our hearts. We need hope in our world. We need strength. But that strength can come only from Jesus Christ. And we have to entrust our entire life. We have to entrust our entire lives to Jesus Christ, but through Mary. And that's why we are here today. We are honoring the Blessed Mary. We will be praying litany to the Blessed Mary. And this is a great way to pray. This is a great way to beg Blessed Mary to intercede for us. And as we know, Jesus Christ came to the earth to save all our lives, to give us a new strength, new hope. And he showed us that we have eternal life. And this is our vocation, to be the saints, to be with him for all eternity. And that promise that we have eternal life is a great promise of future for us. That's the promise of
another life, not just a short life, but eternal life. So let us pray today through the intercession of the Blessed Mary that we can always be with her Son, Jesus Christ. Amen. Let us stand and present our prayers and petitions. Let us pray for Pope Francis that he can be the visible sign of God's will here on earth. Let us pray to the Lord. Let us pray for all governments, leaders, that they can prevent life from the beginning unto death. Let us pray to the Lord. For all those who are rejected by the society, may the Holy Spirit give them strength and power. Let us pray to the Lord. For all those who are persecuted because of their faith, may they receive strength and power from Jesus Christ. Let us pray to the Lord. For those who have died, especially deceased family members of the Pepin family and all who passed recently, may God welcome them into eternal life. Let us pray to the Lord. For our faith community, may the Lord continue to help us speak the truth. Let us pray to the Lord. God Almighty Father, hear our prayers if they are according to your holy and divine will, through Christ our Lord. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive, O Lord, we ask the prayers of your people with the sacrificial offerings, that through the intercession of Blessed Mary, the Mother of your Son, no petition may go unanswered,
no request be made in vain. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, and to praise, bless, and glorify your name in veneration of the Blessed Ever Virgin. For by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, she conceived your only begotten Son, and without losing the glory of virginity, brought forth for the world the eternal light, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore, and powers tremble before you. Heaven and virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exaltation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim. Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus Dominus Deus Sabaoth, et terra gloria tua, hosanna in excelsis, benedictus qui venit in nomine Domini, hosanna.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For to your Son, O Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you will give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, Lord, that we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy this gift we have brought to you for consecration, so that they become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, as his command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you."
In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming,
we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Lord, we pray upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with the Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with our blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Alphonsus and with all the saints, and whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Peter, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you in the compassion of merciful Father. Gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life. Give kind admittance to your kingdom, that we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, to whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. Live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Agnus Dei, idolis peccata mundi. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, dona nobis pacem.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Having been made partakers of eternal redemption, we pray, O Lord, that we who commemorate the mother of your Son may glory in the fullness of your grace and experience in continued increase for our salvation through Christ our Lord. Caris hostia, quae celebrandis ostium, bella premon hostilia. Trino qui domino, sit sempiterna gloria, qui vitam sine termino, nobis donet in patria.
The Litany of the Blessed Virgin Mary.
Lord, have mercy on us. Christ, have mercy on us. Lord, have mercy on us. Christ, hear us. Christ, graciously hear us. Christ, graciously hear us. God, the Father of heaven, God, the Son, Redeemer of the world, have mercy on us. God, the Holy Spirit, Holy Trinity, one God, have mercy on us. Holy Mary, Holy Mother of God, pray for us. Holy Virgin of Virgins, Mother of Christ, pray for us. Mother of Divine Grace, Mother Most Pure, pray for us. Mother Most Chaste, Mother Inviolate, pray for us. Mother Undefiled, Mother Most Amiable, pray for us. Mother Most Admirable, Mother of Good Counsel, pray for us. Mother of our Creator, Mother of our Savior, pray for us. Virgin Most Prudent, Virgin Most Venerable, pray for us. Virgin Most Renewed, Virgin Most Powerful, pray for us. Virgin Most Merciful, Virgin Most Painful, pray for us. Mirror of Justice, Seat of Wisdom, pray for us. Cause of our joy, Spiritual Vessel, pray for us. Vessel of Honor, Singular Vessel of Devotion, pray for us. Mystical Rose, Tower of David, pray for us. Tower of Ivory, House of Gold, pray for us. Ark of the Covenant, Gate of Heaven, pray for us. Morning Star, Health of the Sick, pray for us. Refuge of Sinners, Comforter of the Afflicted, pray for us. Help of Christians, Queen of Angels, pray for us. Queen of Patriarchs, Queen of Prophets, pray for us. Queen of Apostles, Queen of Martyrs, pray for us. Queen of Confessors, Queen of Virgins, pray for us. Queen of all Saints, Queen conceived without original sin, pray for us. Queen assumed into heaven, Queen of the Most Holy Rosary, pray for us. Queen of Peace, Queen of the World, pray for us. Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world, spare us, O Lord. Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world, graciously hear us, O Lord. Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God. Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, we beseech that by thy servants may rejoice in continual health of mind and body, and through the glorious intercession of Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, may be freed from present sorrow and enjoy eternal gladness. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Tantum ergo sacramentum, veneremur cernui, et antiquum documentum, novo cedat ritui, prestet fides supplementum, sensum defectui. Genitori, genitoque, laus et jubilatio, salus honor virtus quoque, sit et benedicio, procedenti ab utroque, comparsit laudatio. Amen. You have given them bread from heaven. Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, who gave us the Eucharist as the memorial of your suffering and death, may our worship of the sacrament of your body and blood help us to experience the salvation you won for us and the peace of the kingdom, where you live with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. The divine praises. Blessed be God, blessed be his holy name. Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Blessed be his most sacred heart. Blessed be his most precious blood. Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar. Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete. Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary, most holy. Blessed be her holy and immaculate conception. Blessed be her glorious assumption. Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother. Blessed be Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse. Blessed be the God in his angels and all his saints. sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment high. Holy God, we praise thy name. Lord of all, we bow before thee. All on earth thy scepter claim, all in heaven above adore thee. Infinite thy vast domain, everlasting is thy reign. Infinite thy vast domain, everlasting is thy reign. Hark the loud celestial hymn, angel choirs above are rising, cherubim and seraphim in unceasing chorus praising. Fill the heavens with sweet accord, holy, holy, holy Lord. Fill the heavens with sweet accord,